Hello, I'm Chris Menard. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Feel free to subscribe and ring the bell. I have a great Excel video for you today. We're going to create a dynamic chart using dynamic array functions. I'm going to use filter, which is definitely needed in this one. I'm also going to throw in the sort function, and I'm even going to do the unique function. So let's go ahead and jump into this video right now. There are chapters and bookmarks down below. Go ahead and tell you this. These dynamic array functions are for Microsoft 365 users, Excel 2019, Excel 2021. I do not believe they're with Excel 2016, but I will put down below all the different Excel versions where dynamic array functions work. So, item number one, before I start creating my chart and using my functions, this is a data range in A1 through cell F16. I'm going to make it a table. That way, if I add records to it, everything gets updated automatically. With a range, it would not. So CTRL+T. CTRL+T works on the Mac and it works on Windows. That'll convert this to a table. Hit OK. If you don't like the look of your table, come up to Table Design. Go to Table Styles and feel free to change it. That works for me. So here's what I want to do. I want to chart the full name in column A, and I want to chart the invoice amounts. But that chart is going to be based on some other field that repeats. So for us, that could be column C. What household type do they have? It could even be based on the state, column E. Or on the source, I probably would not do it on the city because the state comes before the city. I'm going to keep this simple and base it on the household type, family, couple, and single. So here we go. What dynamic array function Excel will only show you certain data? That is the filter function. Equal filter. There are my arguments right there. Three arguments. Two are required. That third one is not required, but I'm going to go ahead and use it. What is your array? If you recall, I made this a table instead of a range. So to do this, watch this. My mouse is right below column A. I'm going to click and pull over to column B. It is picking up my table, comma. I'm on argument number two. What do you want to include? I want to know if the household type in column C is single or family or couple. Make the chart. I don't have it typed here, but I'm actually going to reference cell I2. Hold tight. I'm going to reference cell I2 after I select column C equals I2. Sorry about that. By the way, I could have selected column C and then put in the word single in quotes, but I want to make it so I can just type in something and automatically do it. And then comma, watch this. If empty, not required, but I'll put not found right here. I should get actually nothing or not found because there is nothing in I2. Let's see if that's true. Not found. Go to I2. Let's put in the household type single. It is not case sensitive. They're the people that are single. Notice Carol Roberts and Tasha. I'm going to change this to family, and I should see cell A2 is Kathy. And I do, and might as well just do couple to keep it going, and it's working. I'm going to go back to single. There you go. So I have this working, and I'm about to build my chart, but I want to go ahead and format these numbers. It's going to drive me crazy. Notice I'm picking up some extra in case I add to my table. How do you want them to look? Dollar sign, comma. I want comma, no decimals. That looks good to me. Let's go ahead and make the chart. Two keyboard shortcuts to make a chart. On the Mac or on the Windows, the F11 key will always make a chart in a new worksheet. If you're on Windows, Alt F1 will make a chart on the current worksheet. I just did Alt F1. But let's use the mouse method. I'm inside my data, insert tab. What type of chart do you want? Here's the chart group. I'm going to do a column chart. It is totally up to you what chart you put in here. I'm going to leave my chart right here for now, just over here. Perfect. Let's just test this real quick. Let's go from single to family. And my chart changed. And one more, I like to test stuff. Couple. Yep. Working back to single. There you go. Now I have an issue. Minor issue. Everything is correct that we've done. I like to see in my chart, I want to see this probably going from highest to lowest or from lowest to highest. It is totally up to you. To do that, I don't want to sit here and keep sorting this. I want it to always work. So what I'm going to do is add in the dynamic array function, the sort function to this. By the way, here's my filter function again. I just want to point this out. If I go to cell H6, H7, it doesn't matter. Notice it's grayed out because it's all right here in this cell. I'm going to edit the cell with a double click and add sort. So let's put in sort, S-O-R-T, open parent. There's my array. Here's my sort function. My array is actually the filter function. So I'm going to come all the way down to the end and add a comma, sort index. So inside that filter function, which starts in cell H, whatever, and runs over to I, what column do I want to sort by? It's the second column in that data. Comma, what order do you want? Ascending or descending? I'm going to pick ascending. I'll come back and make it descending. I believe that this is done. Same chart. That chart should change and it should be lowest to highest. Let's see if that's true because the data is going from lowest to highest in column I. Quick edit. Again, back to cell H5. I believe descending. Cool tip for you. I believe descending was a negative one, but I'm not sure. I'm going to delete the one. Well, I'm expecting, where's my arguments? What can I pick? Alt down arrow key. That is showing me my two options here. I know it's hard to see, but descending is a negative one. Data changes, chart change. That is a dynamic array chart. Pretty cool. Let's go do it one more time. Go from single to couple. Still working. Back to single. Let's make I2 a data validation list so I don't have to type. I have a drop down arrow. Multiple ways to make a data validation list. This is on the data tab in Excel. One of my absolute favorite tabs in Excel, the data tab. I use this all the time. Here is data validation. So here's one easy way to get to it. I'm gonna do this. I don't like this method, but I'm just going to show you could. When I click on data validation, the default is you can type in any value in cell I2. I'm going to go make it a list. Here's what I don't like. I've got three different types. I've got couple, family, and single. Couple, comma, family, comma, single. I did not do any spaces. It's one right after the other. Now, if you had something with a space, take, for example, San Diego, you would put a space between San and then Diego. But once you go to a new item, no spaces. Hit OK and look. Family, couple, single. Working. Perfect. Hate that method. I'm letting you know it works, but I can't stand it. Here's what I would do instead. I'm going to actually come in here and delete it. Data validation, clear all. So that's what I did before. Hit OK, hit delete. Perfect. It's actually working. Type in single. There you go. I'm going to make a data validation using the unique function. So over here in column K, another dynamic array function, and oh, I love this one, equals unique. What is it I'm trying to find? It is column C. Again, the mouse is there. It's a table. Click it. That is it. I am done. Family, single, couple. Guess what I'm going to add to this? I might as well just go and use sort again. So let's sort these, comma, sort index 1, comma 1. couple, family, single, always in the correct order. Now, my data validation list, I could have put this on another worksheet in a real life. I would have, but I'm in training mode, so I'm just trying to let you see everything at once. I'm going to go to my data validation. I'm going to make it a list. What is your source? Instead of typing in couple, family, single with commas, just highlight this over here. Click OK. Family, couple, single. Come over here. I'm going to type in no clue. No clue gets added to our unique function. No clue gets added to our data validation list. So there you go. Let me get rid of that. I can't remember who Tasha was. We'll make her single again. And it disappears. Also, one more test for you. I hope you're enjoying this. The reason I made this a table instead of a range is if I come down here and add somebody, am I even in here? Let's not, let's put me in here at 5,000. Be single, Marietta GA, and Google Ads. Perfect. I am single. Let's see if this works. Single. Hey, Chris Menard. Chris Menard. Cool. This was a lot of fun. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope we did a lot of stuff, including making tables, using a data validation list twice, creating a dynamic chart, using the sort function with filter, using the sort function with the unique function, using the unique function to create our data validation list. I appreciate your time. Feel free to subscribe and just have a wonderful day. Thank you so much.